tired and ready to go. You think you have to see Papa?
No.
Why are you not showing yourself?
Because it's all about y'all.
But I'm here.
Trying to see how comfortable I can get in this chair. Because the next week or so, I will be back here. Maybe not in this room, but here. This is just another, you know, false alarm.
Why are you calling
it
false alarm? Like, I hope
false, it's a false alarm.
Nobody want to have a baby right now. But I
right.
Mean,
it's too early. Pressure was high, so. Nyla was a little excited. That's all there was. So, cervix not even open yet, right?
You're right. Tell her to go and lay down somewhere.
So, ain't no dough for her to go through right now.
She just sit down.
Right. So she needs to just relax. But I got a feeling we're gonna be back here in the next week or so, and hopefully we don't have to actually stay and go into delivery.
Now you need to go home and pack your hospital bag,
because
now you're playing.
I don't really need too much to wear. But we will see. Right, Mama?
Hopefully I'm about to
go
home.
Well, Nyla, we're going to see you soon, darling.
We're going home. Blood pressure went down. Service was close. I need like 2 more weeks because nothing is done. I'm not ready. I'm tired. I'm hungry. I'm thirsty. And we ain't ready yet. Just wait like 2 more weeks. But yeah, going home.
Coming soon.
I'm happy.
See you soon, Nyla.
Next time y'all see us in the hospital. Hi YouTube, it's Erin, and I'm just gonna be showing y'all what I packed for my hospital bag for me, baby, and Daniel. So right now, I packed some toothbrush, toothpaste, and I got some lotion, perfume, deodorant, you know, little stuff like that that you will pack wherever you're going, if you're going anywhere, since we're gonna be gone for like 2 or 3 days. And here I have like some body wash, some soap, some lotion, some more lotion, just body stuff, flushable wipes, just whatever I just grabbed and go. Oh, they have like some Tylenol here too as well. I have some soap for Daniel. Still got some nursing bras. Pair nursing bras. This is a shirt, a nursing lounge set for like postpartum, like maybe when I leave the hospital. And you can lift a little thingy up like this and lift it down for easy access. And I might just wear this for when I go home, something comfortable, something to slip on. And these are the pants that goes with it. I also got some socks. Oh, hold on. Shout out to Naita for my Christmas gift. Some little socks to go with that. I also have some more socks. I have some maternity underwear postpartum. So I got me just a little dress just to slip on. You know, just in case I need anything while I'm there. As soon as I get to the hospital, they're going to make me get naked anyway. So it's not like I need all these clothes. So for Daniel, he has shorts, he has pants, sleeping pants, joggers, shorts, and two t-shirts and like a little sweater thingy. He has 2 pair undies and 2 pair socks. That's good enough, right? Because we're going to take a shower before we leave, and we're going to go be there 2 days. So I left this open space right here for like just last minute stuff, like our phone chargers. Stuff like that. Maybe if you want to grab some cologne. Oh, we need to get some snacks. But yeah, we could put snacks in here. This is her diaper bag. So cute. So So I have some wipes right here. I have two passies. It has her name on it. So this is how it looks. So right here we have a few diapers. This is gonna be her take home outfit. This is the headband with a bow, and this is the hat. She probably gonna wear a hat. I might take her picture with a bow too, but for now she have both. So that's that. This is right here, goes with her swaddle. This is a headband. This is two burp cloths. So this stays in her bag. This is the swaddle that goes with the headband. This is her outfit. So here's the outfit. Y'all know I love purple. I don't know why, but that's my color. It's her color. This is just a onesie. Just extra clothes. I have a lot of onesies in here, actually. This two white t-shirts. Two plain white t-shirts, two regular t-shirts, an outfit, a onesie, and her come home outfit. So that's all she has in her diaper bag right now. I feel like I'm missing something. But that's probably all I have for her. I mean, she'll live. I think that's enough to survive, to come home. That's just to come home. Anything else I'm missing, I'll probably figure out on the way. I really don't know what else goes in the diaper bag. But this is it for both our bags. But let me show y'all what I put together. So right here, it's a little welcome sign thingy. So of course she's not here yet. So we don't know when's her birthday or her pounds and ounces and stuff like that. But it took me, I would say, like 15 minutes to put this together. It was very tedious. And I'm glad I did it now. So all I have to do is just maybe plug in like pop off like a few little letters. Cause this took a long time and I didn't think I want to do all that in the hospital. So I'm glad I did it now. And so yeah, so this is gonna be her announcement thingy when she arrives. So this is the closet. All these up here are wipes. All these are wipes. These are her clothes. This is daddy clothes over here. This is mommy clothes over here. Excuse the closet. It has to be reorganized. Here's some Pampers. I don't know, like the larger sizes and the smaller sizes at the top, so easy access, but they're all kind of mixed. So most of her diapers look like they're newborn ones, honestly. But we'll see. We'll try to use all of them. If not, then we could give them away. But so far, this is what we have. I think that's all that I have for y'all. So now, since I'm going through my hospital bag, I'm noticing the stuff that I'm forgetting. And I'm gonna just bring, like, you know, the little pop-off thing, so I know when it's her birthday and stuff like that. So I'm gonna bring this with me as well. Can't forget that last minute. So I'm gonna put all that in the bag. And like I said, last minute, we're gonna grab the laptop, because we're in school right now. School started, so we're gonna need our stuff. So we need the laptop, we need the iPads and stuff right now. So I didn't put those in a bag yet because we need that. And yeah, we're all done. Dan, you want to say anything?
No, I better not be that careful.
I don't think you are. But he don't want to say anything. But that's all I got so far. So see y'all next time.
Huh? Hopefully this is it. Huh? Hopefully this is it.
No, hopefully not.
All right, now y'all, we heading to the hospital. Cause her blood pressure is up and the doctor said to come in. So hopefully this is the last visit. Right, baby?
Yes.
She said take out her misery right now.
I'm tired of going back and forth.
She's tired of it. Awaiting baby Nayla. Hopefully this is it, y'all.
Here we are, back in the hospital again. Anything to say?
Nope, I'm ready to go home. I'm ready to go home.
Awaiting Naila. We have been admitted. Let's see how this goes.
Have been admitted, so
it wasn't a false alarm.
It wasn't a false alarm, so I am just laying down getting comfortable until they tell me otherwise. So this is probably gonna be an all-nighter for us today. But hey, just pray for us. Welcome, Naila. It took you a while.
No more.
No more? I thought you said you had 4 more left in you.
No, I said 1 more. Or 2 more. I
didn't
say 4
more. Well, we will see. Yeah, we will. Good luck.
Alright, y'all. So, happy news. Well, I don't know how I feel about this. But Erin is in the hospital right now. She has been induced. Her blood pressure was too high and it wouldn't go down. So she's not gonna be in the hospital until she has a baby. Today is January 27th, Friday, January 27th. And it is my grandma's birthday, like my mom's birthday. So if Nayla's born today, then they're gonna have literally the same birthday. But if she's born tomorrow, then she's gonna have the same birthday as Lawrence. I am super excited. You guys, I don't know how to feel right now. One thing I know is I don't want to miss anything. I don't want to miss the birth at all. I have been having Erin like record little things about like packing her bags and getting everything prepared for Nayla to come. And now it's time, like for real. It's literally, what time is it? It's 1:57 in the morning right now. And I'm at work. And I don't get off until 6:30. So hopefully Nayla's not in a rush and she's able to wait. We're about to have a baby. So stay tuned for that. I don't know. I was just on the phone with Erin, like asking her to keep me updated and everything like that. Y'all, I'm about to be an auntie. Yeah. The baby is here. Only had 9 days left anyway, so it's about time. Hopefully I'm there to record that process. You're gonna have to wait. Yeah, I guess I'll see you guys later. Hopefully I'm there for it. If I'm not, then I guess we'll see Daniel and Erin's point of view on what and how everything happened. So
check the blood pressure all day. I just see it at night.
We're just on the clock right now. We're trying to see what's going on. Hopefully something come through. But you know, everything is in God's hands, so at this point we're just waiting and praying for the best. All right, quick update. They will be back in here in another hour to check to make sure that, you know, she is dilated, to make sure to see if Naila's head is popping out, if she has opened the door or not. But hey, let's just wait and see till 1 o'clock. We're on the clock.
So it is 5:17 and they just gave me some magnesium because my pressure is still high. So it's supposed to prevent like having seizures and stuff like that, and it makes me feel like crap. Like, My body's hot. I feel nauseous. It burns. And they gave me pain for my side. They're gonna check me in 30 minutes at 6 o'clock to see if I dilate a little more or if my cervix opened a little bit so they could give me the Pitocin. And I have to pee really, really bad. And they don't want to let me get up because they're saying they don't want me to fall. So I have to wait like 15 minutes. And yeah. So right now, this magnesium got me feeling like just straight crap. And the contractions are starting, side hurting, limb pain. But I'm gonna update y'all in about 30 minutes when they check my cervix again.
All right, y'all. So I am about to go to work right now. It is 10:40 something. Still January 27th, 2023. And we are still waiting for Miss Nayela to make her appearance. I'm pretty sure Aaron and Daniel has been updating you guys about everything that's been happening. But she said I'm allowed to be up in there. So I'm gonna go tomorrow morning. Well, she didn't say I'm allowed, but she said that I can come, like just come. I'm gonna go, okay? I'm gonna have to keep you guys updated about what's happening because she has been given Netrosin or something like that. I don't remember the name. I'll put it on the screen somewhere. That's supposed to like actually put her into labor, and it's been like 4 hours since they gave her that. So she should be further along than she was earlier. So yeah, let's head out. Cheesecakes, y'all, from Cheesecake Factory that one of our guests brought, Miss Chandra from Cheesecake Factory. This one is chocolate, this one's a birthday celebration, and this one is, you know what I'm saying, the strawberry cheesecake. It looks so amazing, y'all, like literally. Blessings.
Good morning, guys. Well, it's now 2:45, I'm guessing. Water broke around 2:07. Now we're just playing the waiting game. So, see you soon. Hey, mama. How you doing?
Tired, wet, and just hungry.
So after this, my girl gonna need a whole restaurant to herself.
Don't worry, everybody bring me some food.
You heard it here first.
I am so hungry.
Yeah. Almost there.
Hey y'all. So it is currently 6:30 in the morning, and I am on my way home, about to pack a bag and head to the hospital for the birth of Miss Anayela Telva. Okay, she is being very stubborn right now. When you watch this video in the future, girl. Anyways, she is only Erin is only 2 centimeters right now, even though she's been given the shot at like 3 a.m. But she is currently in active labor, so her water's been burst and all that jazz. And I'm just about to head home, pack a bag, head to the hospital, and I guess I'll see you guys when I get there.
Ah yeah, eh. Every time I come around you, baby girl, something doesn't feel the same.
Hi, Tom. We are on our way to the hospital. It's so good, yay! Everybody's telling me I should just have my own because I'm so excited for this one. I'm like, excuse you? Why can't I be excited without needing to have one of my own? We're on our way to the hospital, y'all. To the hospital. Daddy Bear is right here. I'm Shane. This is my ride. We gotta go film this joint.
We're at the hospital. I'm gonna be hitting over. Your time. I just had a scary moment. Was that scary for you like it was for me? Huh? Well, you was dizzy and out of it, I guess, and Miss Nayula's heart rate dropped.
It was that medicine that they gave me, that shit.
Magnesium.
Yes, it had me feeling bad since they gave it to me. I'm like, I don't like this.
Yeah, they probably gave you too much.
And then they did me on top of the epidural. I felt dead. Like,
yeah.
Felt like I died.
Oh my gosh. Don't say it like that. Okay.
Like, I really couldn't move anything. I didn't feel nothing. Like,
it's like, oh my gosh. I think she said 9 centimeters. She tried it. I was excited. I was like, damn, Nayula must have been waiting for me to come. But apparently, you know.
Six is great.
It is great, but it took a million years to get to six, so.
It's okay to go through the pain for like 2 hours. Mm-hmm. And you go through the pain for 2 days, it's like I almost had a breakdown. I was like, I just can't do it. It's just too much.
Yeah. Y'all, look at this. Sorry, I'm getting distracted. It's okay. Yay. Well.
This is her blood pressure. This is Nayla's heartbeat. This is her heartbeat.
Why is hers so low? Oh, this is hers? Oh, okay.
Nayla's is what, 100.
And babies are supposed to be high like that, so it's not a problem.
Yeah, that whole line bond is parents.
You see all this, Demi? Oh, she do.
That's not her.
I just nearly died.
What you say?
Like, I say, I feel like I just nearly died.
Why you say that?
Because, like, I just blacked out. I don't remember nothing. But now I was just like, I just woke up.
Okay.
But everything just was a
blunder.
Mm-hmm. Like, what's going on? I have, like, all these people around me.
Uh-huh.
All these people at my face.
A little scary for a second there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, it is currently 2, almost 3 o'clock. Erin is at 6 centimeters. and she is currently in active labor. Okay, we had a few nicks earlier, but everything is resolved and we're just waiting. They're gonna be putting her in different positions so that we could speed this along. It is one of the first positions, and then she's gonna be up in there for like an hour, 30 minutes an hour before they switch her. But that's the update, and next time you see me, we're probably gonna be having a baby. All right, we are in position number 2, in the running position with the ball in between her legs, or something like that. Everybody took a quick nap before this shift. I'm gonna go back to sleep. My head's starting to hurt. I don't know why. Probably because I only slept 2 hours. Makes sense. But she said that she's at 8 centimeters right now. So we're almost there. 2 more to go. She only has a little bit of cervix left. And then we're gonna be having a baby soon. It's getting really intense. Like you said, this thing's gonna work, so it's doing its job. Oh, yeah.
So sometimes, remember I was telling you, sometimes babies come out like this. Sometimes they come out face first, face up. Your baby might
finally get to meet this baby you've been brewing for all this time.
Baby's gonna
stay with you.
Mm-hmm.
Baby stays with you the entire time.
Oh,
no nursery. We don't have a nursery here.
Yeah, I'm gonna lift the baby. The baby is gonna zero this with everything is on it. Put the baby down. It's supposed to weigh the baby.
Hey, girl.
38 grams, and I'll change it to pounds.
3080?
Yeah, 3080.
All right.
Mom, 6 pounds, 13 ounces. Do you want to take a picture of that thing?
That was so right.
That's an average, normal size thing.
My mom keeps us open.
Yeah, it's about you. It's about
you. All right, you can get back together again and take it to see mom.
How much for you?
You're a big girl.
You owe me $3.
Right, I'm saying it's you and dad. It's not. So you were 5, Dad, how big were you?
So basically I just brought over here so I could stimulate her more, yeah, and so give her some oxygen, get a jump started.
So yeah,
and it's, like I said, if I had a guess, I'd say it's the magnesium. She probably.
Now you get to hold this sweet baby.
Daniel definitely did cry.
And then I read on the page that you want to breastfeed at that point. And we'll let her settle for a minute, and then and she's showing some signs that she's interested, we'll try. Alrighty.
Wait is over.
Wait is over. Girl, you are light skinned. You a light skinned girl. Look at you. Yeah. You are so cute. Hey, mama.
You said she looked just like Erin's dad.
Yep.
Hey. She's smiling. She really do look like a baby. Oh, wow.
I don't know who she look like.
That's what she look like right now? You're fool.
She look just like her dad.
You cry everything. Oh, my God.
It's not my fault. I'm emotional. Hey. Are you looking at me?
Welcome to the
world. Get a cup.
Ew.
I'm not gonna go get my shirt wet. What you do?
Hmm?
I thought I low-key want some sushi.
Alright, she's here. She's here.
Oh, she has a baby?
Yeah.
What's that? Who do you want?
She's here.
This is Vitamin K.
First time holding the baby.
It's been a long 3 days.
Daddy's baby.
Not her smiling.
Daddy's baby. Hey, baby girl. Hey, mama.
Let me get that one. Can I get you anything?
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, I'm
going to
clean you up. I'm going to wipe off and everything.
How do you feel now that the baby's out?
Mm-hmm.
Very cold.
Just as long as I just
want to sleep. Like,
I'm in my bed. But that's just pain. But it wasn't too bad. Because she wasn't too bad. Maybe like 5 times or 5 push.
Mm-hmm.
5 push.
Yeah.
What about you,
Dad?
I am just happy to have my girl in my arm.
Mm-hmm.
Can't wait to bring you home.
She look like everybody but nobody.
Look like everybody but nobody.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you're gonna catch your own face because everybody else caught their own face.
You gotta get that first before.
Mm-hmm. All right, y'all. So the baby is out, birth is over. This is the end of the vlog. We're closing it out right here. And we just want to thank you guys for watching and hope that you enjoy every little part of the video. Anything you guys want to add?
Mm.
I'm going to sleep now. Hurry up, Daniel. You got to take care of this baby.
I need to eat.
I'm gonna sleep later.
Your mom cooked? She was supposed to. This is what's going in the macaroni, you know what I'm saying? All the good stuff. She got y'all. That boy bun done, bro. All right, y'all, so the food is done. The master chef has done her thing. She has made some girenadia, okay? And then she made the black rice, the mushroom rice, you know what I'm saying? Got some macaroni right here, and give me something so I don't burn my hand.
You gonna
be burning. That maybe. All right, and we got, what is this? The sauce. Ooh, don't that look so good? I better get this treatment when I have my baby. You know what I'm saying? I'm on the way to the hospital right now to bring Daniel and Aaron food that my mom made. I already told her, when I get pregnant, my forehead, like, my wig has, like, receded back, so, like, my forehead looks so big, like, and I can't, like, pull it up because it's, like, glued still. There's people trying to kill me. Anyways, I'm bringing them the food. Don't mind my big old forehead. I'm on my way right now. That's what we're doing. So, see y'all at the hospital.
Different already, yo. You been feasting? Hmm? You good food? How you doing, Daniel?
I am doing good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy, man.
Yes, yeah, sir.
Yes.
As you should be. Say it again.
Not even more happy. Mama cooked food.
She made them the good stuff too.
Yes. Mama made that pressure.
That's so crazy.
Dijon.
Mm-hmm.
That Dijon, Dijon.
That's that king food.
Mm-hmm. And she made them jus grenadja, okay? Jus grenadja. That's a special juice. If you're getting jus grenadja, just know it's an occasion, okay? And he getting jus grenadja. I told them people this morning, I'm eating off the backs of Aaron, Daniel, and Nigella. You know what I'm saying? Eating good off the backs of y'all.
My toes are dangerous.
Y'all been looking at y'all toes. I'm not supposed to know.
I think that's dangerous.
Daniel, too.
Babies look like aliens, bro.
We are on the way to go see Miss Nigella. Everybody say hi.
Hi.
Get them gutted. That's a deal with them. Oh. Hey. Y'all see Lawrence?
Dan, you need to bring me to the barber shop.
Y'all, this is the auntie and the uncle of the baby, Miss Nayela. Laura's about to see the baby for the first time. Mm-hmm. Laura's, how do you feel about being birthday twins with Miss Nayela?
I'm excited.
You're excited about that?
Yeah.
How old did you just turn, Lawrence?
14.
I can guarantee you by the time you get 16, 17, you're not going to be excited about that. Because every birthday is going to be for you, Miss Nayela, Nayela's godmother. So it should be interesting. Because like when you get older, you're going to want to celebrate big and all that stuff. But it's going to be her first birthday next year. So that's going to be like big. But you're turning 15 and it's going to be like, oh my gosh, I want my spotlight. You don't think it's going to be like that?
Not really.
He not no selfish kid, you know what I'm saying? So he don't mind sharing the spotlight.
I am a selfish kid.
Don't say that.
I like things to myself. But if it doesn't, I'm not going to. All
right, child, let's go.
That was so lame. Shit, I don't get what you have to do.
You just recorded it?
No.
Oh, my shit.
Only recorded the last part of what you said.
Yes.
I wasn't gonna post that anyways.
Let's go. Let's go.
Come on. Don't know how to hold babies. Sean, you can see the baby. I'm sorry. Nothing, excuse me. You're gonna see the baby tomorrow. It's okay.
The baby coming home tomorrow.
Hey guys, so this is day 4. We're still here. Lover's just still high and we can't go home yet because mommy's not healthy to go home. Baby's okay. Everybody else is okay. So we're good. So we're just trying to stay relaxed, stay positive, so we can go home, get our pressure down, take the medication. And we was gonna close the video out on the birth, but this is a part of the birth because we didn't get home yet. And we're going to update y'all again when the doctor tell us it's okay to get home. But right now, we're not going home until we get this blood pressure down. So, we'll see y'all in a couple hours because we're going home today. We're going home today.
Time to go home. Bring my baby home.
I'm going home. Finally been discharged. I'm happy because I was about to cry. I was ready to go.
Time to get into our comfort zone.
Bringing my baby home.
Thank y'all for watching.
Appreciate y'all.
She's already ready, huh? And you have the house tag before you walk out. This thing ain't cause a cave pink, brother. I know you took it off, but I see you walking behind.
Welcome home.